Beloved, I know you are fine, and whatever you are watching me from, when you get this video, please post it against to Amankrado. Yes, Amankrado. I'm Dr. Ima Angelobinin's translator. Yes, Amankrado, I would like to ask you a question. Please, and a big please. What at all do you want from Angelobinin? That is the question I would like to ask you. What at all do you want from Angelobinin? I just watched the video this afternoon about what you were saying about Pastor Kevin. That is not my case. That is not my issue. That is not my problem. You know what you want from Pastor Kevin. That is why you've kept on talking about Pastor Kevin, time or that number. I don't care about that. But what matters most to me is, why do you keep on mentioning Bishop Obinim and Jelobinim's name? Every son or child wouldn't sit there for somebody to be mentioning his or her father's name almost all the time. That is why I've come out to ask you this question. Because you keep on mentioning Angelo Binim, Bishop Obinim's name in your videos. What at all do you want from him? What at all do you want from him? You said you've been in abroad for like 6 years, but whatever you are saying in your video clearly shows that you've been given information, series of information, and you kept on attacking people. Why? What has Bishop Obinim done to you? You are saying that you live in abroad, but almost everything that falls on this ground, you make a video about it. My question is, please, 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 what has Bishop Obinim done to you? If you are saying something about Pastor Kevin, I don't have any problem with it, because that is your own problem. You know what you want from Pastor Kevin, and you know people who have paid you. You know people who have given you a series of information that you are lambasting Pastor Kevin. I don't have any problem with it, but please, please desist from mentioning Bishop Obinim's name, because Bishop Obinim has not talked to you. Bishop Obinim hasn't mentioned your name in any of his videos. When I was watching your video, you kept on saying that, why did Bishop Obinim introduce Pastor Kevin when he came to his church? Hey, Amankrado, Amankrado, Amankrado. How many times have I called your name? 3 times. Amankrado. Someone has come from somewhere to work with somebody. Under normal circumstance, every person who is full of wisdom would have to introduce the person to the new environment he has come, so that people wouldn't see him as a stranger. That is rationality. That is rationality. You are saying that when about 4 pastors of Angelo Binim, Bishop Obinim, went to Reverend Obofo's place, you never saw it anywhere that Reverend Obofo introduced them. Amankrado. Amankrado, don't let me say your level of wisdom is very low. Somebody who sits on Reverend Obofo's television, holds mic, work in his church, what introduction do they need? What introduction do they need? I have been working with Bishop Obinim and Angelo Binim, time with Ananba, airport, everywhere. So I don't need any introduction from anybody for people to see that I'm working with him. The moment I'm working with him, we come on television, everything shows clearly that I am working with him. The same way one blow Pastor Xavier and the lives, Pastor Hassan and co, they've also been sitting on his television, live programs and the like. They've been working in his church. So what introduction do they need that clearly shows that they are working with Reverend Obofo? Don't let me say your level of wisdom is very low. Please, all that I'm telling you is, desist from mentioning Bishop Obinim's name. This man is staying at his corner, hasn't mentioned your name before. Have you ever heard Bishop Obinim mentioning your name, Amankrado? Never. He wouldn't even do that. That is why we call him Kwadonyan Sani. He has a record in Ghana here. He has never attacked anybody first. Anybody who attacks him and he will retaliate. That is when people attack him, then he will retaliate. He only comes out to say his man when people attack him first, then he will retaliate. Do you have any video or audio that shows that Bishop Obinim and Angelo Binim has attacked somebody first? That is his record. That is why we call him Kwajo Nyansani. Everything Amankrado you are doing clearly shows that you are from Reverend Obofo's camp. Because everything you are doing clearly shows something has happened. At least if you say you are a vlogger, at least gather information clearly and very well, so that you can be speaking as a neutral person. But you keep on lambasting Pastor Kevin, and you would want to coin certain things by bringing Bishop Obinim in it to show that he is a very bad person. Amankrado, let me tell you something. If even Bishop Obinim is bad, we, his children, we are really proud of our father. At least, you said it in your video that your mom died about 6 years ago or 5 years ago. At least, no matter how your mom was, you are proud of her. You are indeed proud of her. So no matter how our father, Angel Obinim, is, we are really proud of him. Please, Amankrado, stop being biased. Stop being biased, Amankrado. Stop being biased. Because whatever you are doing clearly proves and shows that you are from a certain camp. What at all do you want Reverend Obofo to do that shows that the likes of one blow, Pastor Kelvin, Pastor Savior, and likes works for him? Hey, something that you've been saying, I don't really get you. Somebody has come to a different environment. You don't expect the man of God to introduce this person. What if another person sees him and sees him as a threat or a traitor or a spy? What would have happened? Because everybody knew that Pastor Kelvin was working with Reverend Obofo. Now he has come to work with Angel Obinim. So if Angel Obinim doesn't introduce him to the congregation and people see him at the church premise, people can even say that, oh no, he is a spy. So let's do something against him. That is why Angel Obinim taught it wise, maturely and wisely, that, oh, let me introduce the new pastor, Pastor Kelvin, to every Tom, Dick and Harry, every congregant, so that we will see that, oh, now he is working with us, so that if anybody sees him, he will be known as a brother in IGWC. You said you've not heard it before. What was the necessity in Angel Obinim introducing Pastor Kelvin? In fact, Amankrado, in fact, don't let me say your level of wisdom is very low. Whatever you are doing clearly proves and shows that you are from their camp. All that I would want to tell you is that please let Angel Obinim's name lie. Please let his name lie. All the talks I've spoken, I've never made any insultive word in it. Amankrado, I regard you, I respect you. You are very older than me, so I respect you, I regard you. Please, I've not insulted you. I'm just telling you my mind that please, let Angel Obinim's name lie, please, with all due respect. Amankrado, with all due respect, please. Angel Obinim hasn't ever mentioned your name in any audio or video, so please, let his name lie. I beg you with all due respect, let his name lie. Please, let his name lie. Don't and ever don't please mention Angel Obinim's name in any of your videos again. If you have a problem with Pastor Kelvin, it's your own problem. If you have a problem with somebody, it's your own problem. But please, don't attack Angel Obinim. Don't attack Bishop Obinim, because he has never said anything against you. He has never said anything about you. Neither has anybody closer to him also mentioned your name. So please, and a big please, and a big please, I would want to tell you today that it was very necessary for Angel Obinim to introduce Pastor Kelvin to the entire International God's Way fraternity, so that somebody wouldn't see him as a spy, so that somebody would do something bad against him. And I want to tell you, let me tell you something. No man born of a woman can bring Angel Obinim down. So if you think all these videos you are making will bring Angel Obinim down, I'm telling you, Kwadwo Nyanseni will never come down. Because if Kwadwo Nyanseni, Angel Obinim will come down, not small boys he has fed before, not small boys he has taken care of them before. The hand that once fed you, never bite that hand, because nobody knows tomorrow and nobody knows who will take care of the other person in future. A word to the wise is enough. Amankrado. Desist from mentioning Angel Obinim's name, because you didn't gain anything from that.